Hello, everyone. Today, we'll be talking about the different blood types, more specifically, what they are, what they mean for our health, and possible theories as to how humans have evolved to possess different blood types in the first place. To start, what is blood? Briefly, blood is made up of red blood cells, white blood cells, platelets, and plasma, the liquid portion of your blood. Flowing through your arteries and veins, the primary role of blood, among many others, is to transport nutrients, hormones, and oxygen throughout the body while removing waste products like carbon dioxide. If blood has the same functions in all of us, then how exactly are there different types? Well, blood type is a classification of blood based on the presence or absence of two main factors, those being the type of antigen and the rhesus or Rh factor. Antigens are protein molecules found on the surface of red blood cells. They trigger immune responses within the body, leading to the creation of antibodies to attack foreign items like viruses or bacteria. There are two possible types of antigens on your red blood cells, A and B. A person can be blood type A, in which they only have the A antigen on their red blood cells, blood type B, only containing the B antigen, type AB, possessing both types of antigens, and type O, in which they have neither A or B antigens on their red blood cells, but both are found in the plasma instead. Blood types are most important during transfusions, as blood must be matched to the patient's type. We'll explain this more later. The rhesus or Rh factor is also a protein found on the surface of red blood cells. If your blood cells have the Rh factor, then you're classified as positive, and if they don't, then you're classified as negative. Therefore, there are a total of 8 major blood types a person can be, including A positive, A negative, B positive, B negative, AB positive, AB negative, or O positive and O negative.
Similar to detecting viruses and bacteria, our immune systems can tell apart our own blood cells from one another. If the blood a patient receives is not compatible with their own blood type antigen, then serious consequences can occur, including death. The immune system will attack the incompatible blood cells, producing antibodies to destroy the foreign antigens on the donor's blood, causing them to swell and eventually burst. Although rare, due to medical standards, symptoms of incompatible transfusion may include back pain, bloody urine, chills, anemia, kidney failure, or even full body shock. Ultimately, your blood type determines who you can donate blood to and whose blood you can receive. This is an image of all the possible donor-recipient combinations. Feel free to pause the video. Certain blood types are in extremely high demand for emergency situations. An example of this is type O negative, which is known as the universal donor since it has no A, B, or Rh antigens and is unable to trigger the immune system in any patient despite their blood type. Rh factor compatibility must also be taken into heavy consideration, especially for pregnancies. A phenomenon called Rh sensitization may occur where if the blood of an Rh negative mother is carrying an Rh positive fetus or vice versa, the mother's immune system will produce antibodies that will attack the fetus's blood cells, potentially resulting in the death of the fetus. Apart from transfusions, why else does blood type matter? Current research suggests interesting correlations between certain blood types and disease incidence. The AB antigens on RBC surfaces act as receptors for viruses, bacteria, parasites, and other adhesion molecules, therefore possessing A or B antigens that could facilitate easier entry of pathogens. For example, those in non-O negative blood groups have greater risk for dementia and other forms of cognitive impairment. The blood group was also associated with a higher risk for hypertension, obesity, and cardiovascular disease. People with A blood types have higher incidences of certain cancers compared to non-A blood types individuals. The reason for that is that A blood types have antigens that are extremely similar to those possessed by many types of cancers or tumors. So when tumors begin to grow, the body doesn't recognize the tumor antigens as foreign. Therefore, no immune response is initiated and the cancer can then metastasize. And finally, the actual shape and structure of the antigens themselves play a role in acquiring pathogens. For example, the A and B antigens contain two unique sugar molecules in their structure, which act as an important requisite for the entry of malaria. thus making individuals with A and B antigens more susceptible to malaria than blood type O individuals. Despite the common trends, it is important to note that having certain blood types does not in any way guarantee that you will develop a certain health condition. It only indicates susceptibility. There are a multitude of other factors involved in disease manifestation which should be addressed and further discussed with your healthcare provider. Much like eye or hair color, blood types are inherited genetically from your parents. This image shows all different possibilities in blood types based on inheritance. For example, in column 1, if both parents are blood type AB, then the child may be blood type A, B, or type AB. It is believed the different antigens found in blood types have evolved to respond to the exposure of different types of pathogens, like viruses and bacteria. Although some blood types and their antigens developed through genetic mutations, the main factors that contributed to their evolutionary success were likely exposure to environmental pressures, such as the ability to fight disease. Some blood types survived infections and outlived their rivals. In a way, it was the survival of the fittest blood. The most common theory suggesting the formation of blood groups is that the first blood group was AB, which gradually evolved into the A, B, and O groups due to multiple genetic mutations that have occurred over the years. Researchers believe the mutations leading to eventual formations of type O blood occurred as an evolutionary advantage because type O is the most resistant against infectious disease. Having a wide variety of blood types is beneficial as it can help prevent individuals from becoming susceptible to certain disease and can decrease the likelihood of disease transmission through transfusion, thereby increasing the likelihood of the survival of the overall population. Different ethnic populations also have varied blood types. This can be due to factors such as migration patterns, cultural practices, and geography. The distribution of blood types can be influenced by geography, as certain blood types have advantages in areas where there are prevalent infectious diseases. Additionally, regions with significant mixing and migration are more likely to have diverse blood types than areas with limited gene flow. Along with natural selection processes driven by factors like temperature, humidity, or even altitude may have played a role as populations adjusted to the environment around them. Therefore, we have learned about the different blood types, their medical significance, and a little bit about how they evolved to be in humans. So next time you go get your blood drawn or decide to donate some of this liquid gold, remember the diverse, life-saving ability of your tiny blood cells.